Wrinkles of Washington. How did it come to be? Well, years ago, I think it was 1993 or 4, Newt Bucher and I were on the board of directors for Senior Services, and we were talking about the fact that Senior Services often it was the last organization to get any donations. We were talking about how could we raise more money. Newt Bucher had seen a performance down in Fresno, California, of a group of all seniors doing performances.
A friend of mine had taken me to a rehearsal that he was having, and it was a group of seniors called New Wrinkles. And it occurred to me, we need money. We're retired. We can do those things. And Michelle Penmore, they was also on the board. And she says, well, if we can get it going, I'll direct it. And then I went to the Washington Center and found out if they had any dates open. Well, they had a weekend early in September, which was called Grandparents Weekend. I thought, perfect.
And Newt and I had previously done theater together. We got together and formed a board of directors and started coming up with ideas. We put an ad out in the newspaper for an audition, and we were disappointed. We only got about 4 people. So we put more ads, even in Shelton, all around. And the next time we had auditions, there was about 24 people. And in walked this man completely in clown outfit, down to the shoes and the nose and everything else. He didn't need the nose, really. It was vaudeville. He got up and did a song and dance for us, and both Newt and I looked at each other and smiled and said, we've got a show.
My name is Eileen McKenzie Sullivan, and I am the Executive Director of Senior Services for South Sound. And I am so thrilled to be able to say how important WOW has been to Senior Services. First of all, just to say it up front, over the many years of their wonderful productions, WOW has donated over $300,000 to help low-income seniors be able to access all of the programs and services here at Senior Services. Be questionable whether we would be here or not today without their incredible and faithful support. And let me tell you, people so looked forward to seeing those shows. I think it gave them hope that seniors can do such amazing things as performers. And of course, it always spoke to their heart. Songs from their young adult years, their youth. It was just a wonderful, wonderful experience. I just want to say thank you. Thank you to the founders of Wrinkles of Washington that kicked it off and got it going in our community. Thank you to the performers. Thank you to the volunteers. Thank you to everyone that made it such a vital, incredible community group. And of course, from the bottom of my heart and the board of directors of Senior Services, as well as all the folks we serve, thank you for your incredible, generous gift to Senior Services.
Well, I'm Rick. I'm the editor of the Senior News, have been for a long time. I've always been pushing Wrinkles of Washington, for one, because I love the fact that they give away money to the senior people of the community. That's just great. And so I've never charged them for advertising. We always run articles, and usually with a picture if we can, to get as many people to the shows as possible. The Senior News has like 40,000 readers, and it comes out every month, and people seem to go to the show because they've read about it in the paper. When I found out about WOW, I just had to help them out in any way I can. I'm sorry that they're stopping what they're doing. I'm really thankful they were able to toss a few bucks the Senior News way along the days, and I wish all the people well in their future endeavors. Take care.
Hello, my name is Linda Hughes. The Wrinkles of Washington meant a great deal to me, to my dad, and to other people that I know. The music, the costumes, the tap dancers, everything was very tastefully done, made in a really nice way, The music was wonderful because it was music that we knew, music that I knew, songs that my dad sang. Dad had a life-changing stroke. He could no longer drive. He could no longer talk. He could only say yes and no and hi and go, and that was really it for years of time. The Wrinkles of Washington offered for a fee a copy of their program, and they would send it to you. A few weeks later, it would come in the mail. I would order it, and then I would take it home to my dad. He saw the programs over and over and over again, and the people around him saw the programs over and over and over again, and they traded them back and forth through the church for years of time. In order for us to keep our jobs and keep our dad in good spirits, we took him to the Olympia Senior Center STARS program. He was there for 17 years, and he also attended the Lacey Senior Program. And with the services that the STARS provided and the transportation, we were able to keep our dad at home until the day he died. And that was exactly what he wanted, and STARS and the senior centers helped us to accomplish that.
We'll work on that. Come on, we'll get up there. Let's go.
Oh, hey, well, you're going to spot us in these outfits. What are we going to do?
Did you bring a coat?
Have you got a coat, lady? Oh,
hey,
wait a minute.
Hey,
that looks
thank
good.
You, sir.
Never mind.
I got some.
Oh, that's a good plan.
I got
some. Jewels.
It happened many years ago when I was a very young man of 55 and was invited to join the group. It's called WOW. And I thought, okay, I like being on stage. I'll give it a try. I remember playing with vaudeville, and we did some things together, and the first show, we were criminals who had just escaped from jail. I'll never forget this as long as I live. We were supposed to come into the auditorium just after this freeze up on stage of everyone getting onto a large cruise ship. And so there they were standing, frozen in place. The lights started to flash. It looked like a prison break. There were sirens, there were whistles, and we came into the auditorium and down to the front. And right across the front underneath the stage through what would be an orchestra pit in front of the audience. And one of the usher ladies had stashed two upcoats because we were dressed in orange prison garb and carrying a bag of jewels. And as we got to the front row, Vod, of course, who was Mike, said, "We need a disguise. We're going to need something to cover these prison coats." And I said, of course, "Yes, we do. Let's find something. Here's a man right here. He's got lots of coats. Let's grab a couple of these, okay?" And Vod said, "Grab a couple." So I grabbed a couple, but he didn't let go. And I pulled again, and he didn't let go. And I'm pulling harder. And I'm thinking, if I wasn't Mike, I could tell this guy to let go of the dumb coat because it's part of the act. But the usher lady had told him, "Hang on to these and don't let anybody have them." and he was doing his part. He also smelled a little bit like alcohol, so that might have helped. Anyway, I finally jerked these two coats out of his hand after having been there forever, and we rushed through the little doors, up three steps, onto the stage, and there's Michelle, who was calling from the sidelines, and she turned to us and said, "Where have you guys been?" And we could hardly hear because her teeth were clenched so tightly. And we just continued right on. We didn't even stop, rushed onto the stage. And then we had to explain to her afterwards, it wasn't our fault. We had some help from somebody in the audience who was holding our coats. But that's one of my first memories of WOW, and it only continued like that for 20-some years. And, oh, to have done that, oh, I was very, very rewarded for the time that I put in, the things that I got out. The enjoyment and the people. Oh, performing with WOW was something that you cannot imagine unless you were there. What a wonderful time of my life.
Random luck! How very kind of you to invite us to your party. Oh, isn't that sweet? I'd just love to sit over here close to you. Oh, you're just a dear. Oh, thank you so much. Oh, my. Isn't she just a trash? I love it.
I'm Mary Margaret McFarland, and I joined Wrinkles of Washington in 1995. I loved being in the chorus, and eventually I got to sing my first solo in our sea voyage, and it was Someone to Watch Over Me. I loved that part so much, I got to even kiss the leading man, so that was wonderful. I also remember Once Upon a Wrinkle that was so clever. I'm sure all of my wrinkled friends would remember that with pleasure because vaudeville was in that. I truly miss Wrinkles and will never forget the countless hours of fun. What a marvelous way to raise money for various local charities. My thanks go to Michelle Penberthy and those grand committees for their dreams of senior talent singing in Olympia. So it was just wonderful to meet all of these fabulous musical people and be part of Wrinkles.
Hi, my name is Nancy Lowe. I was dancing with St. Peter's Hospital Happenings in the show that they had each year for quite a while, where I met the choreographer for Wrinkles of Washington, Lillian Egan, and she encouraged me to start coming to the Wrinkles of Washington rehearsals. I only did it for 1 year in the big show and then one in the springtime because I was working full-time and we did a lot of gigs, so I was having a little trouble keeping up at home. However, Lillian and I remained good friends until she passed away several years later. There was a very humorous thing happen when we were practicing at the Washington Center for our show. After we were through, the director was talking with us and she pointed out one of the guys. She said, "You look like you were scared to death." And he said, "Well, I was," and we all burst out laughing. I'm really glad that I was able to be in it, although I wish I could have done it for a lot longer. I did go see a lot of the shows after that.
You want to do a number two?
Hi, I'm Jeannie Vosburg. WOW was a wonderful place to ad lib. If you said something that was especially funny, they'd just add it to the script. One of my favorite parts was the stagecoach in How the West Was Wrinkled. I played the shotgun rider on the stagecoach, and Newt Bucher played the horse. I couldn't resist the line, "I'm so hungry I could eat a horse," and he galloped off in fright, and they added that whole part to the show. I liked WOW's inclusiveness. They made a place for my husband and his photography so that he wouldn't be left at home all alone when I was out doing WOW things. He always supported me and gave me places in our home to practice the tap dancing and all of the extra things that I needed to do as part of WOW. I loved building scenery. That was one of my favorite activities. I really enjoyed the time that I spent with the people backstage. It was an opportunity to get to know everybody better, and it was enjoyable on all fronts, and we all had a good time together. I treasure my friendships, and so did John.
It was just a figure of speech.
Colin, I was attracted to Wrinkles of Washington when I went downtown and saw a poster for the show in 1996. And I had a friend at work who was in that show. And the poster looked so attractive because it was old people. So I found out it was for old people, performing for old people, yet give an outlet to people that usually don't have an outlet. And that's what I was for. So I went down and auditioned and took me in, and I stayed in 27 years. And I tried to get other people to join as I went. You may hear from some of them. Until I couldn't dance anymore. And that's about it.
Vaude DeVille, what a guy. He showed up on our first audition dressed completely as a clown, even with the big feet and the red nose and the whole works, and we didn't know where this guy came out of the woodwork. But he was there for every show. He was a prolific writer. He could act any kind of a character. Vaude was one with a very huge heart. He was always the comedian. The day he auditioned Bring Him Home for me, I sobbed, because all I ever knew Vaude was as a comedian. But he also had a side to him that was a very gentle human being. He took care of his wife in her illness for many, many years. He took care of his mother-in-law in her illness for many years. Vaude was one of the backbones of WOW. The shows would not have been complete without him.
Bring him home. Joni Force, and I first learned about WOW in 1994. Singing always gave meaning to my life since I was a small child. And I was taken by the notion that an all-seniors group could display remaining talents and contribute at the same time financially to our local senior services. It was lovely to be on the big stage performing at the Washington Performing Arts Center, and also special and smaller gigs throughout our community. I especially enjoyed the smiling faces in our audience. It was wonderful. Fellow performers were such fun and positive about aging. My favorite number was Hey Daddy, referring to a common phrase regarding sugar daddies popular in the 20s, 30s, and 40s. I am so grateful for this joyful experience that enriched my life from 1994 to 2007.
Hi there, this is Georgia Williams. Without any background in tap dancing, I was recruited in that 1997 show to be a dance hall dancer in While the West Was Wrinkled. And this eventually became my role as a performer in WOW shows and gigs.
Began one day in 1994 as our hula teacher Melva Kirkbride had asked our Aloha Sweethearts to come to WOW tryout. There we met WOW founders Newt Bucher and Michelle Penberthy, plus Vaude DeVille. WOW for me, Sally, meant an active, productive, fun, varied use of my time, interests, and strengths. I truly enjoyed meeting new people almost every day while I was a grant writer, dancer, singer in the chorus, acting, and being in gigs. Then, best of all, I was privileged to be a part of a team of truly talented performers, including my husband of 68 years, Don.
Thank you. I'm William Sigworth, and I was in the stripper dance, and my lovely wife choreographed the stripper dance, and we had a wonderful time. There was 8 sometimes of us men and sometimes 12, and we was always fighting for the right to have the first spot.
My name is Mary Patnode, and this is my tribute to WOW. My years in WOW brought great joy to my heart. The opportunity to dance, to act, always excited for a new part. And now, with WOW gone from my sights and performances made still, warm memories will continue, and I can recall them at will.
Watching Joni Roper own the stage wearing a gorgeous blue sequin gown and doing a fantastic rendition of Blues in the Night. I thought, oh, wouldn't it be so grand to be up on that stage doing that? But of course, it was just a dream. Then I took a chance and auditioned for WOW. My dream person, Joni, walked up to me and said, I have a new best friend. This is Joni, big-hearted, straightforward, super talented Joni. When I felt close enough to tell her I would love to sing her song sometime, Joni said, Jeannie, I don't own any song, and you should go for it. Joni was like that, always encouraging, dedicated to what was best for WOW, working many hours at home to make our shows the best entertainment the seniors in our community could get year after year. She always had faith in the organization she had helped found. Maybe I shouldn't bring this up, but you need to know that Joni had lupus, a nasty disease that attacks your whole body. For years, she fought against seizures that were at times debilitating, and yet Joni showed up without fail for shows and gigs with her head held high and her smile and song at the top of her game. Let her performance speak for itself.
that plans so is soon forgotten.
My name is Beth McClymont. I got involved with Wrinkles because my husband was a member. And so I worked backstage with the mic-ups and helped with costumes. There's a lot of things that I remember about the performances. Wrinkles in Paradise was one of my favorites, where the characters went through this box machine and came out different on the other side. I think some of the things that really stuck with me a lot was vaudeville, especially singing Old Man River. That really brought tears. A lot of the things like Chuck Gorley playing Elvis with all the ladies couldn't wait for Elvis to get out there. And the dancers, especially the Stars and Stripes Forever. And just there's just so many things that I have got parts of in my memory. And so I just want to thank all everybody from Wrinkles for letting me become a part of the show. Thank you.
Hello, I'm Tom Thompson. I'm a retired member of Wrinkles of Washington. I performed in many of Wow's productions and enjoyed all of them. But my very favorite performance was When Jen Was Sin. I had seen a couple of Wow shows and had expressed a strong interest in being a part of their group. I auditioned with a short tap number. I was nervous as I could be, but seemed to make it through okay. Everyone seemed to like it. Later on, I was asked if I would like to read for a part, so I did. After the audition, I was offered the role of Mayor Clem Claghorn. When Jen Was Sin, what a great and exciting show it was. So, When Jen Was Sin was my first and favorite performance. But the most important thing about the experience was acquiring a great number of new lifetime friends. What fun we had. I will remember all of you and love all of you forever.
Skies above, don't fence me in. Let me ride through the wide open country that I love.
My name is Linda Hughes. I went to the Wrinkles of Washington and enjoyed the program, but what I enjoyed the most was the song called Don't Fence Me In. It was my dad's absolute favorite song. I was in the middle of the program, seated in my chair, and out steps someone else's dad singing Don't Fence Me In. I know most of the words by heart, and the tears began to roll down my face. He knew it exactly the way my dad would do it, and it just made me cry. When the program was over, I went home, and I just knew it had been an awesome, awesome night. The next morning, I went to my dad's house and said, "You won't believe this, Dad, but somebody else knows your song." He looked at me and I said, "I went to the Wrinkles of Washington, and somebody else's dad stepped out on the floor, took the microphone, and sang, Give me land, lots of land, and all the rest don't fence me."
Guys, on my cayuse, let me wander over yonder till I see the mountains rise. I want to ride to the ridge where the west comes. my senses. Can't look at hobbles and I can't stand fences. Don't fence me in.
Al, I came into the Wrinkles of Washington through Vaude at a jam session. He was talking about a show that he was in. He told me I should join Wrinkles. I asked him how old I had to be. He said he had to be 55. I told him, well, you're a little late for that. But I came to the first audition, and then from there, I got involved in Wrinkles, started playing different variety shows and plays that we wrote. I helped on the set committee, the board, and I was on the script writing committee. I think the one that sticks with me the most is a gathering of Wrinkles, the 50th high school reunion. And it was a lot of fun. You had the remnants of the high school band, of which I played drums and banjo. And we played a bunch of songs. I also acted on that as coach. And when I wasn't acting, I was sitting behind the drums and playing, and Dale Seeley playing banjo, and Bob Williams playing sax, and Wendy playing piano. The one song that I really stuck out with me was when we played Bye Bye Blues. I started out playing drums and I stopped playing. I picked up the banjo, went down, sat next to Dale, and played the song a couple of times through, and then went back to the drums and finished it out. And it was a lot of fun. There's so many shows to choose from, and this is one that stuck in my mind, and I really enjoyed doing it.
Was a primetime tapper for 13 years. Susie Scott, who I'm speaking for, worked together. She told me about the primetime tappers, and when I was 55, I was able to join. I'm reading this for Susie because she wasn't able to be here to do this. I was fortunate to be a part of the most amazing group of talented people in the Olympia area from fall 2000 through 2006. My first show was in September and was taught by Helen Sigworth, the most patient, caring, and inspiring dance teacher ever. There were between 13 and 17 of us all over 55 and various stages of the knowledge of the tap dancing. She was one woman miracle to us all. She chose all the music and spent hours on choreographing, and then turned all of us into the entertainers we all dreamed about. Every spring and fall, we would learn new dances and put together the costumes, do each other's hair and makeup, and then do our best to wow each and every one of our many wonderful fans. In between our big shows, we would visit the surrounding Elks Lodges, the clubhouses, and nursing homes to entertain and bring joy to many. I have never enjoyed anything more than my time spent with this group of special people.
deal. And the proudest time in my adult life was when I belonged to Wrinkles of Washington. I thought I was old and done, but I wasn't. I was probably better than I've ever been. And I just want everyone to know the joy that it has given me in my life. I hope that the people who were kind enough to come, and believe me, they always came, the theater was full. I hope they had as much joy as I did. We could have never done it without them, and each time we did it, you were all just incredible. So thank you from the bottom of my heart to all the incredible people that I performed with, some of the nicest people I have ever met, and to all of you wonderful people who took time out in your lives to come and hear us. I'm sure that your life was made better just as mine was. Thank you all.
Hi, I'm Michelle Panberthy. Wrinkles of Washington, or WOW, was a major part of my life for many years. Having the privilege of directing many of the shows and even performing in some, it always gave me great pleasure. I was a singer. My very first solo was at age 4. I loved being on stage, albeit I'm a very shy person, but put me on stage in a costume and I can do just about anything. Especially comedy. And with WOW, that was one of the major things I aimed for all the time, was comedy as well as beautiful music. I met many, many wonderful performers in WOW, and we did a great thing by raising money for senior services. I'm sorry WOW had to end, but there's a season and a time for everything.
I'm Linda Deem, and I danced with the Primetime Pappers for 12 years. After about 3 years, I went deaf, had cochlear implants, could not understand the music, but I had a dancing background, and I learned to cope, and I actually went one whole show totally deaf because my batteries went dead, but nobody knew it. I thoroughly enjoyed it. Sharon Williams introduced me to it when I was 56. It was a lot of fun, a lot of work going up there. What did we go up, 2 times a week?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, for a 65-mile round trip, but that's okay. I liked it, and I enjoyed it. And I'd like to thank you, Helen, for the opportunity of accepting a deaf person.
Beautiful to me.
I am Ardell Schwilk. Ken was a talented vocalist, actor, performer, a classic showman. He had a passion, drive, and capacity to embody a wide variety of roles. He entertained from his heart and aimed to share the human experience. We are all fortunate to have seen him perform. His tears were real, his voice filled with conviction, and his passion resounding. Ken was a man of great depth, character, and intelligence. This afforded him the gift to convincingly grace an audience and walk in another's shoes.
Looking back on the memory of the dance we shared.
For most of us, Wrinkles of Washington was an opportunity we could not provide for ourselves, a venue and an audience. Whether it was a large theater stage like the Washington Center for the Performing Arts, or a cafeteria at a retirement facility somewhere in Puget Sound area. The large theater shows were great, but dozens of road shows each year were our best opportunity to really put on a show up close and personal for our audiences. We used our own sound equipment as we traveled places north and south of Olympia and displayed our singing, dancing, and instrumental talents to many folks who could not get to our big theater shows. Even though rehearsals and preparing for shows were lots of work, the return we received from audiences made it worthwhile. The money earned through the road shows and the theater shows was donated to Senior Services for South Sound and a few other deserving causes. I am thankful for the experience I gained as a Wrinkles of Washington entertainer, board member, and a co-director for some of the spring shows. I learned so much from so many people, many who have passed on. As a 58-year-old aspiring entertainer, Wrinkles of Washington gave me all the opportunity I needed to gain confidence and grow as an entertainer in the years to come. I will always be indebted to WOW.
I could have missed the pain, but I'd have had to miss the dance. It's my life, it's better left to chance. I could have missed the pain, but I'd have had to miss the dance.
My life. I fear. I thought that you'd want what I want. Sorry, my dear.
After having been with Sweet Adeline's Barbershop Chorus and Quartets, I received excellent voice training from them, looking to branch out and solo, and was so excited to sing on the same stage with the likes of Joni Roper, Robert Williams, Dale Seeley, the Primetime Tappers, and so many more. Each one taught me so much about never forgetting that we were there for the audience first and foremost. It's so hard to describe being adopted by this wonderful family and allowed to grow and bring joy and pleasure to those for whom we perform. What you don't know about is the fellowship and unselfishness that goes on backstage in the dressing room. As we laughed and wept, while sharing in each other's lives, we were always brought back to the bond of music that kept us all going. May we never forget Wrinkles of Washington when we hear a tune that brings it all back to us in the future. God bless you all.
But where are the clowns?
to give. Don't you know that this hand washes that one too, when you're good to...
Hi, this is Charlene Goodrich. I've been a singer my whole life. When I got into my 50s, I started voice lessons and was wondering where and how I could perform. One Sunday, I noticed in the newspaper there were auditions for a group called Wrinkles of Washington. It was very intriguing, and I auditioned and made the team. I sang in their gigs and then in their yearly show on the big stage at the Washington Center for the Performing Arts. What a lucky day it was when I saw that announcement for auditions. Where else could 55 and olders have the opportunity to perform to big audiences? It was just fun. A memorable performance for me was doing When You're Good to Mama from Chicago and sharing the stage with Vaude DeVille, an icon of senior citizen showmanship. The thing I learned from my experience with WOW was you don't lose your talent just because you're older. I feel very lucky to have been able to perform with them.
So what's the one conclusion I could bring this number to? When you're good to mama, a mama's good to you.
I am Helen Sigworth, and I want to thank WOW for giving me the opportunity to become the Primetime Tappers choreographer. 6 years, 17 women, loyal, confident, never missing lessons, help put all of this together. Primetime Tappers became an amazing dance team.